This is the moment.
Now, please welcome the queens as they walk in procession with their escorts. First, outgoing Palomar Queen Jerry Deutsch. Jerry is escorted by Fred Deutsch. Her interest in dancing started at his sister's wedding when she was 12 years old and was literally swept off her feet dancing a polka with her brother's friend. Now that sounds like fun. Her mom's cousin played the accordion, and family parties always included dancing. This year's state queen and Los Angeles' queen is Susan Johnson, escorted by Chuck Johnson. One year after they were married, they went to a wedding and saw a couple dancing ballroom. That was it. They started lessons, and the rest is history. Queen Alberta Valentini from San Diego was inspired by old Fred Astaire and Ginger Roger movies and loved both versions of Shall We Dance. What an enticing question that is. Her escort is Peter Valentini. The Golden Gate is represented by Queen Emma Steed. She is escorted by Don Hubbard. The Sound of Music was the inspiration for her lifetime of dancing. Certainly music fit for a queen. And San Fernando is represented by Queen Leanne Wong, escorted by her husband John. Answering the question of what inspired her to pursue ballroom dancing, Dion's response was, putting on the Ritz in Young Frankenstein. Or was that Frankenstorm? I don't know. Leon, you might need clunkier dancers for that number. Bakersfield's Queen Joanne Giorgio is escorted by Frank Lombardi. As a young girl, she was involved in dance lessons and dance groups. Finding ballroom dancing was a great fit for her, and to enjoy dancing even more, and that she has. From Visalia, Queen Wendy Story is escorted by Paul Story. Her inspiration, a private party held at a Fred Astaire dance studio that had beautiful pictures of ballroom dancers, and she said, I want to do that. Signed up for a lesson. Queen Sharon Crisp from Fresno. Escorted by Neil Sharon. Her inspiration, a private party held at a Fresno Astaire dance studio, which had beautiful pictures of ballroom dancers, and said, I want to do that. Will the crown and flower bearers please enter? The crown bearer tonight is Scarlett Lum Mott, granddaughter of Linda and Elliott Lum. The flower bearer is Kristen Lum, the daughter. Now, please welcome Palomar's incoming queen for 2016, Linda Lum. Linda is escorted by her husband, Elliott. Her inspiration in Jason Baldwin dancing, Linda was especially moved by the words of to Anne Murray's song, Could I Have This Dance? Those words are in your program and describe the romantic grasp that ballroom dancing has had on Linda and surely on many others of you here tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, Palomar Smooth Dancers proudly presents our new queen, Linda Lum. Queen Linda and Elliott will now dance a waltz to Anne Murray's Could I Have This Dance?
Get her.
I'll do. And now we'll pal Palomar's past queens, join in.
Each day I live, I'll try to give you happiness. Without some heartbreak, heartache and happiness go hand in hand. But it's worthwhile, every tear and every smile. I remember every mile I walked with you.
And we'll queens from all chapters join in. Chun had been longtime friends of Linda and Elliott. It was they who got Linda and Elliott started in ballroom dancing and enthused that passion on an open 11,000 square foot eucalyptus dance floor in Honolulu. Mike and Lori have flown in from Hawaii for this special occasion. The story accompanying these competition dancers and the relationship with the Luns is briefly covered in tonight's superb program. Please welcome Mike and Lori as they help celebrate this occasion by performing the International Waltz theme from Rudy.
Thank you.
What a treat that was. First, Fresno's Queen Sharon Crisp and Emil Sharon. Sharon Crisp. Celia's Queen, Wendy Story, and Paul Story. Wendy Story. Bakersfield's Queen, Joanne Giorgio, and Frank Lombardi. Joanne Giorgio. San Fernando's Queen, Leanne Wong and John Wong. Leanne Wong. Golden Gate's Queen, Emma Steed and Don Hubbard. Emma Steed. Queen Alberta Valentini and Peter Valentini, San Diego. Alberta Valentini. State Queen in Los Angeles, Queen Susan Johnson and Chuck Johnson. Palomar's outgoing queen, Jerry Deutsch and Fred Deutsch. The crown bearer and flower girl, Scarlett Wolf, Mott, and Kristen Lum. And Palomar's new queen, Linda Lum and Elliott Lum. Performance. Please welcome Kerry Kloss and Mike Kalashaw as they perform a Viennese waltz.
Take a breath, pull me close, and take one step. Keep your eyes locked to mine, and let the music be your guide.
Won't you come out
bedroom off to the side.
We just wanted to prove that the picture on the back of the program without a photo. The real deal, we got our same outfits on, and we want to sing one of our favorite songs. We sang this when my mother was on her deathbed and all our kids were around singing to her. We had a good friend at our ukulele group leave for France, and we sang that to her. And for us, this is a special occasion because we have some new friends. And we are singing our special song for you.
This past year at Berkeley. I never expected that such a good life experience would happen to me when I joined the Smooth Dancers. When I think of NSD, that it was formed as a male-only club, I wonder how it is that the Crown Circle is not a circle of dancing kings. But as for me, I am so happy that some wise person came up with the idea of this royal idea to honor the women of our club in such a special way. The common bond that we queens share is the absolute thrill of our coronations. And to my sister queens from the other chapters, it's been such a kick sharing this thrilling ride with you. I absolutely loved participating in each and every coronation and learning about you through your unique theme and special details that you put into your celebrations. Each time I attended one of those coronations, I relived my own, and it brings back really good feelings. When everyone asks me if I am sad that it's over, everyone asks me that. I have to say, sorry, it's not over. The phrase, once a queen, always a queen, is not just something that we say to make the outgoing queens not feel so bad. Now just look at Mary Anderson, yes. Donna Thornton, Marsha Hansen, Miriam Moses, Peggy Lee, Debbie Atherton, Sue Takimoto, and Darlene Drury. These are our queens. And wow, to be counted among that circle, talk about honor, that is an honor. They continue to show their love for the ballroom dancing and the preservation of our club. They prove that it's only over when they choose it to be over. We have amazingly wonderful women in our club. A few of them are here right now, Carol Kemet and Marion Sandler. You guys are great. And I'm only too anxious to have them also have this opportunity, and all the others in our group that are not here, but they do an amazing job. So no, I am not sad about passing on this honor to our dear Linda. It is a most humbling experience to be queen when you realize that your chapter members have dedicated so many hours and put forth their most creative talent all year long to make this club fun and a real success. We've got quite an eclectic group, and I love all the members of the Palomar group. And being queen has given me a boost in knowing and growing to love the members of the other clubs. Before I end, I would like to thank my friend. He not only came along with me on this journey, he accepted the nomination. He accepted the nomination to be our club president, which totally blew me away when I heard this, because I said, what are we doing? Here am I following Marcia, and now Fred has to follow Peter too. But we have had the time of our lives, and we thank you so much. It's been so much fun. Thank you all.
Well, thank you, Jerry. And it's going to go on and on. And now we can have our new queen, Linda.
As you can see, Jerry is a hard act to follow. So she is just fabulous, and I am so honored that I'm going to be following in her footsteps, and that I was honored by being selected to be queen this year. She's a wonderful example. I'll have a difficult time filling her shoes. But I want to thank all of you for coming, because none of this would be possible if people didn't show up. And you all took the time to come spend a whole weekend, practically, driving to San Diego area and coming to the coronation to make this a wonderful event for me and for my family, because I've got part of my family here. All of my dreams came true last night. All of my expectations were exceeded last night. And all of this is due to all the worker bees supporting the queen. It just reminded me of all these little busy bees, because everyone has worked tirelessly from the day they called me up and said, would you like to be queen? I'm like, really? I better say yes, because I may never be asked again. They may change their mind. Anyway, it's been a wonderful experience, and like I said last night, everything went beyond anything I had ever expected. And I expect this whole year will be more of the same when we attend the coronations of the other chapters. So I'm looking forward to fulfilling my queenly duties, following in Jerry's footsteps, and with a lot of help from some of the other queens who can tell me what to do. And it's really been a pleasure to thus far. So I think with that I will end my comments, but I know that next year I probably will be up here again in feeling really, like I have really gotten to know many of you much better, and feeling very happy to be been the queen for that year. Thank you.
Thank you, Linda. And just an added note of appreciation to our sister chapters for not only taking the time to come down, but for braving the traffic that I'm sure everybody had to struggle through to get here yesterday. Thanks again. So now that the food is really here, please.
I was just
practicing. And then the rest of it will be on the adult program as the line kind of winds down. Just slowly move up there and give everybody time to eat.
No, it's more.
Now, ladies, you have to eat. I'll.
I went to